It's time to face the facts. A dangerous convergence of unsustainable trends in the economy, energy, and the environment will make the 20-teens one of the most challenging decades ever. That's how Chris Martenson starts his book, The Crash Course. The main premise of The Crash Course is pretty straightforward. He puts it simply at the beginning of his book, massive change is upon us. What does he mean by massive change? Basically, that our material prosperity is at its peak. That from here on out, we have to be prepared for a future of less and not more. He comes to this conclusion by focusing on what he calls the three E's, or the economy, energy, and the environment. Although we have major issues in all of these areas, for Martenson, what makes these problems and predicaments so much worse is the fact that they reinforce each other, and that most people won't even see these issues until it's too late. Let's dive into Martenson's argument by finding out how we got to this point, and it all starts with energy. Whether you know it or not, energy is the master resource, as Julian Simon says it. The reason is, before you can have anything else, you need energy first. And in order to understand how we went from small villages to having supercomputers in the palms of our sweaty hands, you have to understand the role of energy and why you need surplus energy for a civilization to grow. This was a difficult topic for me to grasp, so let me tell you a story that really clicked with me. Imagine you're a farming family a very long time ago. Your farm produces enough food, or technically chemical energy, to feed all five of you and no more. But in order to produce that food, it also takes all five of you to do all the work. Martenson would describe this as a zero net energy surplus, because although you are producing enough food to feed all five of you, it also takes all five of you to get that energy. Now let's skip forward a bit and imagine that you get a horse. This horse enables you to do all the work that previously took your whole family to do. The harnessing of animal power has allowed you, one person, to produce enough chemical food energy for five people, which leaves you with a surplus of four chemical energy. This surplus means your family members no longer have to work in the fields, but can pursue other professions, interests, or education. In other words, this surplus energy has enabled economic growth or prosperity. Now let's skip forward a lot. Imagine one day you get a tractor that runs on oil. This tractor has 100 horsepower, which allows you to do the work that previously required 100 horses. This new power source allows you to expand your farm so that you are generating enough surplus food so that 499 people don't have to work the farm and can choose other occupations instead. All because we harnessed oil. Now, obviously, this is a very simplified example, but it gets the point across because this is basically what has happened for a very long time. Essentially, we have kept harnessing more and superior supplies of energy, from pre-industrial human, wind, wood, and animal power to industrial coal and oil. Fossil fuels in particular make so much surplus energy that our world economy has grown to previously unimaginable heights. Now let's see how our modern economic system fits into this energy picture. When we think about the future, and especially our economic future, most of us assume that it will be bigger and better than yesterday. And in fact, the way our current monetary system is designed, it requires the future economy to be exponentially bigger tomorrow. And not required as in we'll have to modify some laws if the economy doesn't grow, but rather required as in the economic system might collapse if it doesn't grow exponentially, just like you would collapse if you suddenly couldn't breathe. Why this is the case is a little too detailed to get into now, and Martenson explains it in his book, but you can see this exponential growth over the last century in things like the US GDP, the total stock of money, or M3, and total credit market debt. So how does an economic system that requires exponential growth match up with the energy picture we talked about? Pretty damn perfectly, actually. In 1913, our current monetary system was established, which happened to be the same time we're discovering exponentially more energy sources, natural resources, and inventing better technology to catch for them. So as our economy grew exponentially larger, we found the raw materials to supply that growth. And since everything has worked out for the last 100 years, no one really sees a problem with this system. But we're starting to see the warning signs appear signaling that, Houston, we have a problem. Which brings us to our final E, the environment. Martenson breaks down the environment into two categories. The first is the idea that Earth is a source of natural capital. In other words, its oil, coal, copper, iron, etc. are all here for us to use, and are the first raw materials in our economy. But after many years of extraction, we're running out of everything, from our energy sources like oil to many of the raw materials we use as well. Secondly, think of Earth as the final resting place for all of the waste and pollution. Our ecological systems are urgently flashing warning signs, with our ocean acidifying at the fastest rate in 300 million years, the sixth mass extinction in Earth's history happening right now, and our stable weather patterns that we rely upon to grow our food becoming increasingly chaotic. So now we come to our current predicament. Our economy needs to keep growing exponentially or it will collapse. A bigger economy will need more energy and more raw materials. To make more energy, we'll need more coal and oil, and for more raw materials, we'll need to mine more natural resources like copper, iron, etc. But planet Earth only has a certain amount of resources, and it appears we've reached a peak production for many of these. Additionally, our environmental ecological systems are clearly showing signs of stress. Let's go back to my farming example and imagine the situation in a new light. Remember, with that tractor, you are able to produce enough food to feed 499 people. Well, what happens if you're only able to obtain 50% of the fuel you need? Well, now our equation changes because you can only feed 249 people. Then let's imagine fuel availability drops by 50% again. Now your farm can only feed 124 people. Again, this is a very simplified analogy, but if you continue this process out, we can see there was a peak to our prosperity that relied upon cheap, plentiful energy. This lack of cheap, plentiful energy predicament is made worse by the fact that we have tons of other issues to deal with, like our demographics, funding social entitlement programs, few alternative energy substitutes available, and a likely global economic collapse from our current monetary system. In short, why massive change is upon us. Hey guys, it's Nick. I really hope you enjoyed this super brief summary of Chris Martenson's book, The Crash Course. If you haven't read The Crash Course, I'd highly recommend you pick it up. I've read a lot of books on the economy and peak energy and some on the environment, and this book tied everything together in a way that helped you see the bigger picture in a way that not a lot of books I've read that have ever done. So if you're interested, then please purchase the book. If you use my Amazon affiliate link below to buy the book, or anything else on Amazon, I get a little kickback, which enables me to make more awesome videos for you guys. And if you like books on history, economics, or big ideas, then get notified when I post a new video by either subscribing to my email newsletter list or to my YouTube channel. See you guys.